Hi, so we're looking at logic-based questions based on puzzle. So data is given to you. Try solving on your own to get your answers. So in the meantime, let me just solve this. There are seven lecturers teaching seven different subjects. Their annual salary is divided into three. This one, there is one is 3 to 5 lakhs, 6 to 8 lakhs, and 10 to 13 lakhs. So three basic slabs are divided into. The salaries are distinct integers. There are only 3% of the salary slab of 10 to 13. So three people at 10 to 13. F wants to a lakh. So F is a part of 10 to 13. B and G earns lower than F's salary slab. So I'll put it separately. So B and G is lower than F slab. So maybe it will be one of the two slabs, 3 to 5 or 6 to 8. D earns more than only 1%. That means D should be a part of 3 to 5. And if you arrange it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, lowest to highest. So you look at D earns more than only 1%. Who teaches economics? So economics is that person. The person who teaches chemistry earns more than the person who teaches geography. And their total income is 15 lakhs per annum in the same slab. So with the same slab, it has to be 6 and 8 lakhs, 6 to 8 lakhs. And it's only possible if one is earning 8 lakhs, one is earning 7 lakhs, 8 plus 7, 15. So that means we can definitely say that geography, because two people in the bottom slab, three people in the top slab, because, okay, if you read it properly, there are two persons only in a salary slab of 3 to 5 lakhs. So there will be two people at a salary slab of 6 to 8 lakhs. If I'm dividing into salary slabs, two and three people. Now coming to that statement, these two people, that is the person in chemistry and geography, has to be in the middle slab. And chemistry earns more than who teaches geography. So chemistry will be here, geography will be here, fourth and third. Okay, this is the lowest and this is the highest. Okay, next. Two people in 3 to 5 lakhs. The person who teaches history earns lower than F, but higher than those person who teaches biology. So higher than biology. And lower than F, and three in the same slab. If we're in the same slab, it has to be 10 to 13 lakhs because F is in that slab. So F is 12, that means history has to be 11 and biology has to be 10. That's the only possibility. So that means this has to be 10 has to be biology, 11 has to be history, and F has to be the highest with a salary package of 12, 11, and 10. That's how we get. Here it will be 8 and 7, 15. Okay, then F does not teach physics. So this is not physics for sure. So physics has to be then second person, physics D. So F will teach the only last subject left, which is mathematics. So F will teach the last subject which is left, which is mathematics. The total annual income of G and A and B and E is 17 and 19 lakhs. So if you look at, if it has to be 17 and 19 lakhs of G and A, B and E, where will it be? We know G and B are in a slab of lower than, you know, 10 to 13. Now, let me see if they can be in 3 to 5 lakh slab. If they're in 3 to 5 lakh, suppose one of them is 5. To make it 17, I require one more with 12. Not possible because already F is with 12. Okay, to make it 19, I require someone with 14. Not possible because the maximum can go up to is 13 because slab is 10 to 13. Right? So I know 5 is not possible. So technically, both G and B should be in a slab of middle slab. Okay, G and B has to be in a slab of middle slab. So G plus A is 17, B plus E is 19. So we can make out that G and B both will be the slab in a middle slab. Now let's see how 17 can come, because I have to combine 11, 10, 8 and 7 to get 17 and 19. You will realize that 11 plus 8 can be 19 and 10 plus 7 can be 17. From that you can make out that G has to be 7, A has to be 10. And from here you can make out that B has to be 8, E has to be 11. Because A and B are in the, sorry, B and G are in a lower slab. That's the reason. So that's how you get. So that will be, sorry, E in the highest slab. And the last person who is left here is C. And different C's and D's salary is 2 lakhs. And they are in a 5 to 3 lakh salary. So which is only possible if D is 5 and C is 3. You get all the information. Okay. Because B minus C is 2. And if both are in the lower slab. So we can make out D is 5 and C is 3. From that we get the complete picture. So which subject does F teach? If you look at back, F teaches mathematics for A option. What is the difference between annual income of the one who teaches biology and the one who teaches physics? So if I look at biology is here, physics is here, 10 and 5, the difference is 5 lakhs. Which combination represents the annual income of a person and a subject he teaches? 7 is chemistry, no, 7 is geography. 10 is history, no, 11. 3 is economics, yes, 3 is economics, see. Just to confirm, 11 is biology, no. And 5 geography, no. So we get only C option. That's the answer. Who among the following earned double of D's annual income? So if you look at D's annual income is 5, double of it is 10, which is A. So get D option. And which of the following represents the sum of the highest annual income in each slab? Which is 12 plus 8 plus 5, which is 25. We'll get the answer is 25 lakhs. Right? So with that, you get the answer. Thank you.